Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala Rasulullah. Abad. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to ask for the path of guidance. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. Path of guidance, which is the path? The path of those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed. The first and foremost among them is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to ask also for protection from misguidance. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim wal-dhalin. Two ways of misguidance. One is direct disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which incurs the anger of Allah. So every action that incurs the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every person who incurs the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes under the purview of maghdubi alayhim. Those who incurred the anger, those who invited the anger of Allah. May Allah protect us from that. Every action which incurs the anger of Allah is an action of disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is an action of going against the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this incurs the anger of Allah. So Allah said, ask protection from that. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Those people who are misguided, those people who might be doing something with a good intention, but that intention does not serve the purpose, the intention itself, it does not enable them to do what is beneficial for them. So with good intention, people commit shirk. With good intention, people are going to temples. With good intention, people are doing things which are prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu looked at people coming out of a church and he said, how sad. He started, he had tears in his eyes. People asked him, why are you crying, Amir al-Mu'mineen? He said, how sad it is that these people have so much of good intention. They want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and so on. But yet they are doing something which is shirk. They are worshipping other than Allah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from that. So any action which is direct disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or any action which is still disobedience of Allah, even though it is done with a good intention, the intention alone does not satisfy the fact, or does not cover the fact that the action itself is haram, the action itself is wrong. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us on the sharia of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to keep us on the sunnah of his habib Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to keep us like that, and to take us in that state. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyil kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain bi rahmatika arhamar rahim.